It's recess time for the kids at this school in the heart of Istanbul. Their chatter is both in Turkish and Armenian. The Karagazian school is one of 20 Armenian schools in the city. Its 200 pupils follow a Turkish and an Armenian program, plus religious instruction. For Easter, bunnies and eggs have appeared in the classrooms, proof that the teaching of Armenian culture has become possible again, a century after the massacre of hundreds of thousands of Armenians by the Ottoman Empire.
We celebrate our holidays together. We have teachers of Turkish culture and we try to celebrate their holidays and our holidays together. We try to live this double culture and of course we invite the families.
Yasmin is picking up her two children, Moon and Sun. The family lives a few streets away in the Bamanti neighborhood where Muslims and Armenians live together in harmony. The family members speak Armenian among themselves, including in the street, a sign that Armenians now feel more at ease.
When I was younger, we kept everything hidden. We couldn't speak Armenian in the street. We never took that risk. But at home, of course, we did, in secret. When I was in primary school, I remember my father insisting that we should take Armenian lessons at home. It was important for him that we should speak Armenian at home.
The Rostomian family arrived in the Black Sea region of Amasya in the 1950s. Yasmin likes to look at photographs of her great-grandfather who was killed in 1915. She hopes that this year's commemorations will be a chance to talk more freely about her people's tragic history that the Turks have kept under wraps, but she feels should now own up to.
Perhaps I'm wrong, but I'd like them to say, "Dear Yasmin, for our failings," but of course they don't know what happened back then.
Turkey still does not recognize the genocide and it can't be mentioned in history books. Anyone who does bring it up risks going to prison for insulting Turkey.